it ain't over till it's over. A young preacher friend spoke in a gospel meeting back in January and talked a little bit about the relativity of time. He illustrated it with two questions. First was, how many of you thought 2019 would never end? Almost all the young people raised their hands. Then he asked, how many of you can't believe it's already 2020? Almost all the older folks raised their hands. Today, the question would be, when will 2020 end? And the answer would be a unanimous never. Cause just when we think the never-ending crises are over, up pops another one. However, don't despair. We can survive, even thrive, despite the seemingly endless series of crises. Don't give up or lose hope. It ain't over till it's over. When God allowed Israel to lose to the city of Ai after the sin of Achan, there was great despair and disappointment among the people of Israel, especially Joshua. In fact, while the defeat was most embarrassing and shameful, his reaction seemed quite a bit overboard. His lament was as if they had been driven out of the land and it was all over, Joshua 7 verses 6 through 9. But God told him to get up and get busy because it wasn't over until it was over, Joshua 7, 10 through 15. So he got up, discovered the sinner, and sanctified the nation. Then God told them to go take Ai because he had given it to them. It was over when God said it was over. This is an important lesson for all of us, in life in general, as well as in our relationship to God. We are often surprised by the ability of others to snatch victory from the jaws of defeat. We see it all the time in sports, but it happens at school, at work, and in family life. More importantly, it happens in faith as well. People who seemed unredeemable, wicked sinners, suddenly convert and turn to God. Sin that we thought we would never defeat is defeated. And perhaps most important is that forgiveness is made possible in Jesus. As Paul said in Romans 7 verses 24 and 25, wretched man that I am, who will set me free from the body of this death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ, our Lord. All because of Jesus, who snatched victory from the mouth of defeat. After telling about how evil Jews and Romans had killed Jesus, Peter said this, but God raised him up again, putting an end to the agony of death, since it was impossible for him to be held in its power. Acts 2, verse 24. So, just because 2020 has been a hard year and may get even harder, hold on to faith in Jesus. Don't quit. Don't give up because it ain't over till it's over. Well, this morning minutes in the Bible is over, but Lord willing, there will be a new one tomorrow. Until then, this is James McClenney hoping you have a great day.